you're still on Integromat and need to migrate to make, but you have no idea how to do that and you really want to avoid downtime, then watch this video and I will walk you through the exact steps that you have to take in order to upgrade to make seamlessly. Hey, my name is Manuel Gig and I'm the founder of Techflow.ai and we love automation. We help others understand automation in a lot faster way. And today we are going to cover how you can migrate from Integromat to Make. So first, simply go to the make.com website, go to Make platform, and it will prompt you to log in. If you have an Integromat account already, go to create an account, and then type in the same email address that you've been using on Integromat. When you do this, it will recognize you and it will ask you to sign up with your existing Integromat details. And then next you will see an upgrade hub, which looks like this, with all the organizations that you have access to. I have to blur everything here, but we will take one organization of these ones now to demonstrate you how this upgrade process will look like. So first, simply create the Make organization with a click of a button, select the region that you want to go to, in my case it's EU, and then begin upgrade. On the next screen, it will ask you to install all the custom apps that need to be migrated or need to be installed in your account, because these are the ones that you have been using. So you have to click on install all of them in order to be able to use them in your new Make organization. And after installing them like this, you can continue, and then it will show you all the scenarios that can be migrated and those that need to be modified. So in case you have the same webhook being used in multiple scenarios, it will show that this needs your attention. And then you can open the scenario in your new tab, you can modify it, add a new webhook to it, and then go back to the screen, click on back and click on continue one more time. And then the screen will refresh and load the most current data. And that way you can work through all the scenarios that need to be modified, or you can simply unselect them and migrate them at a later time. Of course, you can't do this forever, so you should migrate everything in one go. Then you will also see non-migratable scenarios. These are the ones that are not possible to be done on Make. Usually it's because the app is not installed on Make, or the app developer hasn't migrated his app yet to Make, and therefore you can't migrate that scenario. Then the scenario is ready to migrate. You can also filter for it, so you can say, I don't know, like accounting, and then you can only select these ones, or you simply select all of them and then either use migrate manually or fast migration. And in most cases, the fast migration is the best way to go. An alternative would be to go to migrate.make.com and then sign into your source account, which is your Integromat account. Then sign into the target account on Make, where you already have an existing account, and then continue. And here you can select the organization that you want to migrate from source, which is Integromat, to Make. So for example, I'd select whatever, this one over here, and I want to migrate it to this organization and a backup team, for example. And then simply press continue. I already have all the apps migrated. So that way you can also migrate multiple Integromat organizations into the same target folder or a target team on Make. So let's look at these ones. I have all the scenarios ready to migrate. There's no errors, so I can use the fast migration and then click on fast migration and let's migrate them. Start migration, and you can see it runs through, it does everything for you, and now everything worked. So we got everything transferred over, and I can click on go to target, which automatically locks me into that team and shows me all the scenarios that have been migrated. Now, your Integromat account was automatically paused, so you don't, the scenarios that are now active on Make have been paused on Integromat, so they are seamlessly continuing to run. Let's look into how this looks like on Integromat now. On Integromat, if I check the scenarios, you can see that they are all migrated. So you can see the migrate attack over here, and all scenarios are turned off, which means they won't fire anymore. And if I go to the webhook section, it actually shows the original webhooks got forwarded to my new make webhooks. So the original forwarded to blah, blah, blah. For all scenarios, they are forwarded. So I don't have to do anything and like change the webhooks in my source. I simply have to migrate and make will take care of it. You can also view the original webhooks by simply clicking on it, or if you hover on it, then it will show in the browser at the bottom left side. You can also right click on it and copy clean link if you want to know what the original webhook looks like. Then I suggest over time that you go into your make account and go to webhooks, and then you can see the new webhooks and simply copy them and go to the source system and replace them over time. So you use the make webhooks directly and not leave them forwarded from Integromat. The Integromat forwarding will work, they said, forever. I'm not sure about that. So just to be sure and safe, I would replace them with the original make webhooks. One more thing, this was a free account, but if you are on a paid account, then you will be billed via Integromat until you add the payment details to your new make account. So go to organization and then add your payment credentials, and then from that time on it will bill you via make. And you are on the legacy plan, so you will have the same pricing as you used to have on Integromat with the same operations. If you need more operations, or if you want to make use of the additional features that are available on the Core, Pro, or Teams plan, then you have to switch to one of these plans and you will lose that advantage of the legacy pricing. But if you switch to annually, you can see the Core plan has literally the same pricing as the Integromat pricing, so you're not having to pay more for this one. I hope this helped you do the migration and feel safe about it. If you need any more help, I will also link the help documentation of the migration in the description below this video. So you can also review that one with a step-by-step instructions of how to do the migration. Thank you very much for watching this video. Like and subscribe this video for more content about automation and make.